White Station Theater presents a no-budget serial, Return of the Blue Ghost! Chapter 14, The Deadly Double Cross! While Claire Gray remains a prisoner of the evil Martian dictator Crank Gore, Claire's young wards, Mary and Diana, have taken it in turns to take on the role of the heroic crime fighter, the Blue Ghost! During their latest tussle with the forces of evil, Mary and Diana find themselves in possession of a new weapon, the atomic-powered Superman, and have brought him to police headquarters. While attempting to communicate with this awesome vessel for destruction, the police station is soon under siege by the ruthless Green Spectre, who uses a remote control device to once again bring the atomic-powered Superman under his control and unleash its awesome power against all who oppose him.
Behold the price you pay for playing the hero, Blue Imposter. Soon, this entire building will come down, burying you all underneath it, putting an end to your crusade! Come, leave them to their fate!
Please! Help us! Don't leave us like this, please!
I gave you an order!
Please, big guy! Old chum! Save Lorna and Lois, please! Do not damage! Negative!
Please! Please save my sister! Go! Please! Please save Lorna! Please!
Thank you for saving my sister. Quickly, we will take the Earth Woman as captives.
No!
No! No! No! Come, we'll leave these insects to their fate.
Come. No.
Holy unlikelihood! Did you see that? It saved Lorna and Lois!
Yeah, oh, if only we were so lucky. I don't think we can hold up this wall much longer. Go, save yourself. If you survive, at least the Blue Ghost will go on.
Holy heroism, and that out on you? How many sisters do you think I've got? Just let me think.
Time's a factor, you know.
I've got it. If I can boost the energy source using the cold light I was working on earlier, it will finally increase your strength and let you move the wall.
Wait a minute. Isn't that the stuff that kept blowing up in your face because you kept overloading it?
Well, sure, if you want to focus on the negative.
What are you getting paid by the hour?
Holy rush job. Patience is a virtue, sis. If you just hold your horses, I'd be finished.
Here goes nothing.
Holy headache. Are you all right?
I am. Thanks to you.
We aren't cut out for this, are we?
No. I mean, look at me. I even left the ghost gloves back at the cave. Let's face it. There's only one true Blue Ghost. And it's not us. Come on. Let's get up and get everyone out of here before we really bring the house down.
Report, Marcia! Speak! Why did the atomic-powered Superman disobey the Green Spectre's orders?
It did not, Lord Craigor. As I explained, I had commanded it to take the Earthwoman as captives. It was in my judgment that in case the Blue Ghost resurfaced, it would be wise to have hostages.
Had Lord Krenker's orders been followed, there would be no more Blue Ghost. Isn't that true?
The Blue Ghost has proven most accomplished at snatching victory from the jaws of defeat. Even now we've heard word that he was able to save those we thought doomed. So my foresight should be rewarded, not questioned.
You think you should be rewarded for disobedience and failure?
With respect, Lord Krenkor, if you did not trust me to lead, you should not have made me head of your invasion force!
How dare you question the word of Lord Krenkor, you insolent little—
No! She is correct. Marcia has proven herself to be a cunning warrior on the battlefield. And I believe her wittle gambit has been proven fruitful. The Blue Ghost has managed to escape his most recent brush with death, which has left us with the perfect bait with which to trap him. Where are the girls' comrades?
I had them taken to the warehouse downtown.
Excellent. You will go to the Earthlings in the guise of Linda Leighton. There, you will aid them in alerting the Blue Ghost as to their whereabouts. There, you will use the atomic-powered Superman to finally do away with the troublesome insect known as the Blue Ghost.
All hail Mars.
All hail Mars.
Miss Grimm, this battle is all but over. Your champion, the beloved Blue Ghost, will soon fall to my forces. Then, one by one, your towns, cities, nations will bend to their knees and proclaim me their new master.
The people of Earth will never accept a tyrant like you. They will come out of every corner of the globe and push back against you until you are forced back into that hole you crawled out of.
Why do you resist so? Under my leadership, this world will enter a new era. An era of peace and prosperity, such as it has never seen before. Don't you see? It is my right to rule. It is my destiny!
Creatures like you go about your lives causing nothing but misery and destruction. Fueled by greed, or anger, or pain, you bring nothing but chaos. You look back on the broken pieces of your life and pull together mistakes and misdeeds and dare call that destiny? I feel bad for you, Krenkor.
We shall see how philosophical you are when your beloved Blue Ghost is crushed beneath my boot heel!
How could you do this, Sombra? It's not about power or even warring nations. How could you do this to the people of Earth? How could you betray your own home? Home? I have no home. Hunted, despised, living like an animal. The jungle is my home.
If that's true, it's only because you made it so. My father gave you a home, a family. And then you betrayed him and stole his research for that peace-loving death ray. For what? Power? Money? What good is power and money to a person if they're alone in their own home? And in their heart?
Pretty words, Claire. But I'm afraid they are far too late for you. And for me.
I know you're there.
I've been looking forward to this meeting for some time, Blue Ghost.
I'm afraid I can't say the same.
Your young ward fought with great valor. She's well trained, if a bit sloppy. You should be proud to see her so strong. In the end, however, she is nothing more than an imposter.
I wouldn't get too confident. Mary and Diana are young and resourceful.
Seems you taught them well. A shame they didn't take the time to learn. Of course, the same could be said for you, couldn't it? Your father always said you had a tendency to run before you could walk.
You knew my father?
Know him! He named me.
Across town, at an old warehouse on the docks, valiant reporter Lorna Hargrave and her plucky sister Lois are being held captive by the forces of the Martian invasion fleet, little knowing that soon they would be pulled into even greater peril from the conflicted Martian agent. For soon, Marcia arrives, accompanied by the atomic-powered Superman. However, whose side she is on is a mystery, even to herself.
What's the guy's name on first base?
No, what is on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
One base at a time.
Well, don't change the players around.
I'm not changing nobody.
Take it easy, buddy.
I'm only asking you, who's the guy on first base?
That's right.
Okay.
All right.
I mean, what's the guy's name on first base?
No, what is on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
Oh, he's on third. We're not talking about him. Now, let's go.
Now, how did I get on third base?
Why, you mentioned his name.
If I mention a third baseman's name, who did I say?
I do not understand this Earthling humor. If the fat human is unclear to the player's true name, why does he not simply explain his confusion to the skinny human?
I agree. This lacks the logic and grace of Mars humor. This Abarty and Christeller do not compare to the comical yet sensible acts of Exeter and Brock.
I know. If these are the best minds the Earth has to offer, they're practically begging us to conquer them.
I love Charlie McCarthy.
We have arrived.
Affirmative.
But before we go any further, why did you ignore your program? Why did you save them?
Error.
What error?
Programming, error, programming, crush, kill, destroy, hurt, negative, sad, obey cannot.
Why? Why can you not?
Programming, in error, programming, crush, kill, destroy is wrong. Marcia, Commander, not know this?
Yes, yes, I do. But who told you it was an error to cause pain?
I told me.
You're right. It is an error. We will no longer be a part of it. Follow my plan. And together we will free our comrades and put an end to Lord Prankwer's tyranny once and for all.
All hail Mars!
Get up! Report!
The Earth creatures have been secured, Marcia.
They're unharmed, I trust.
I do not understand. Of what concern is the well-being of these insignificant beings to us?
Perhaps you would just keep them as pets, as children do.
Oh.
Silence! I have no time for your senseless prattling. For you all remember the plan. Earthlings must believe I have been a prisoner all along. You will allow myself and one of them to escape. I'll see to it that they contact the Blue Ghost and lead him to an ambush. Do you all understand?
We understand and obey.
Good. Let's get started. Unhand me! Let me go!
Silence, human! Get in there!
Ow! Stop! No! Wait! Wait! Shh! That sounds like Linda!
Those no good Martians must have gotten her too.
Great, soon we'll have enough for a baseball team.
Oh, please.
I'm just trying to make this better.
Really?
I'm hungry.
You're hungry?
Yes, I didn't
eat. That's what you're thinking about right now?
Are you kidding me? We're tied up together. What else am I supposed to think about?
Getting out, obviously.
You got any bright ideas?
No.
What is the meaning of this?
We found this, we captured this female as she was trying to sneak in and rescue the others.
She said she was sent by the Blue Ghost to buy his brands. We got her before she could make contact.
Very well, lock her up with the others.
Woo! Oh. So they got you too, huh?
Yes. They wish to use us as bait to trap the Blue Ghost.
What else is new?
Wait, but what if that doesn't work? What if the Blue Ghost doesn't come? What will they notice then?
Take a breath, sis. What's Mom's 143rd rule of reporting?
A reporter who isn't kidnapped isn't doing their job right.
That's the spirit.
Not fear, my friends. I was able to equip the atomic-powered Superman with a knockout gas pellet. Once I release the signal using this device, it will release the vapor into the air, causing our captors to fall asleep. Once unconscious, we can contact the Blue Ghost. It will only take a moment.
Yes, Lois. Something smells fishy about this. Back at the police station, I heard that walking bucket of bolts call her Marcia before it turned it into Swiss cheese. I don't think we can trust her.
But Lorna, she just said that she can get us out of here.
I know, that's what she said, but what's Mom's 52nd rule of being a reporter?
Here, I'll trust nothing.
Exactly.
Partly now.
Well, what do you know? They're dimmer than Gahagan during a spelling test.
The plan seems to have worked, Linda. They will be unconscious for several hours. That will give us ample time to contact the Blue Ghost. Send a general distress call on all known frequencies. That should get his attention, I hope.
Attention! Attention! This is Linda Layton from Project Mighty Jack.
Attention! To anyone picking up on this frequency, this is Linda Layton of Project Mighty Jack. I must get a message to the Blue Ghost. Repeat, this is a message for the Blue Ghost. I must get a message to the Blue Ghost. This is a message for the Blue Ghost. Please commit once to the warehouse district. Lot 97. Repeat, the warehouse district. This is Linda Layton of Project Mighty Jack. I must get a message to the Blue Ghost. Repeat, this is a message for the Blue Ghost.
I must get a message to the Blue Ghost. I repeat, I have to get a message to the Blue Ghost. Lot 97.
Traitor!
I think you've had enough, young miss.
I'll tell you when I've had enough.
Just not working!
That should do it.
Can't fix it.
Why do you both look so glum?
We blew it, Wilton. Every chance we had, and all we did was make things worse.
All we ever wanted was to be like Aunt Claire. But when the chips were down, we went belly up.
That is true. Your Aunt Claire is a true hero. Brave, selfless, a natural leader. I must confess that despite my frequent complaints, I could not be prouder of the good she's been able to do and the people she's been able to help. Just as I am proud of the two of you. When it really mattered, you put yourselves in harm's way for those you care about. Did you make mistakes? Oh, of course you did. But do you think your aunt did not when she first donned the mask? We often don't remember our hero's youthful beginnings. So it is easy to forget that they are human, capable of failing, just as we are. What's important is that we learn from our mistakes. That's what makes a true hero. What is it your Aunt Claire's dear father always said?
It's not the machine, it's the person inside.
Exactly. Now, see to it that you both remember that.
Diana, I'm picking up a message on the ghost radio. It's Miss Layton, and she's with Lois and Miss Hargrave, and they're down at the old warehouse district, and... Oh no. She got cut off. Mid-sentence.
Yikes. You know what that usually means.
Trap?
Trap. So, what do we do?
The world still needs a blue ghost, you pieces.
My brains, your courage, together, we can make one decent hero. Rather uncomfortable. I gotta side with you on that one.
Welcome to the Hostage Club, kids. Discomfort comes with the membership card.
How did you, Mom, deal with this day after day after day?
Well, I made a game out of it, and Joyce makes jokes.
And that helps with the crushing fear and sense of impending doom?
No.
Oh, do yourself a favor, kids. Lick your lips.
What? Why?
That's why. When the gag comes off, your lips are going to be very chapped, assuming they're still attached to your face.
Please, let the girl go. She's innocent in all this.
Silence. This is the price you pay for showing concern for these insignificant beings over our mission to colonize this planet for Mars.
Indeed, of what concern are these lower beings to you? They're nothing more than insects to crush our boot heels under.
She's a fool. This bothersome bug has poisoned her mind, and she's still suffering for it.
Were we still on our home soil, the High Court would do well to punish you for your betrayal through torture!
Oh, there will be no need for that. She will pay the ultimate price. And in doing so, help us eliminate the final shreds of resistance this world has. Did you think I was a fool, Marcia? That I wouldn't notice the atomic-powered Superman not following commands, starting to think for itself, and you lying to shield it from me.
What have you done to him? Why is he not responding?
It is a machine, Marcia. I turned it off. I also took the extra precaution of deactivating all of the weapons. Save one. The one that will be used to destroy you and put an end to the family line of the Blue Ghost. As you may have noticed, these restraints are no normal ropes. In reality, they are a highly sophisticated fuse. Naturally, when the children playing the Blue Ghost arrive, the first thing she will see is her beloved friends in peril. Of course she'd have to save you, and why wouldn't she? But when she tugs on these special bonds, she'll set off a chain reaction that will destroy you all! Wiping the atomic-powered Superman's memory clean, removing all traces of free will. Let's go. The blue imposter should be arriving shortly.
Blue Ghost, this is the Violet Spirit. Do you read?
Violet Spirit?
Well, we can't both be the Blue Ghost in the field, can we?
Oh, I like it. Well, Violet Spirit, this is the address Miss Layton gave in her SOS. I can't see anything, though. Can you?
Well, I'm picking up 3 life forms on the other side of the door, but no other traces anywhere. You're free to proceed, but be careful.
Holy rescue! Lois! Miss Hargrave! Miss Layton! Blue Ghost, the Violet Spirit, they are all here!
What are you waiting for? Get them out of there!
Right! All right, everybody. Give me one moment. Miss Hargrave, give me 1 second, please. These ropes are simply very tight.
What's this? Could this truly be the end of the Blue Ghost? Has the evil Green Spectre finally outwitted his youthful adversaries? Will the Earth fall to the forces of Krankor and the invading Martian fleet? And what will be the fate of courageous Claire Gray? All answers will be revealed next week in The Final Secret, the last thrilling chapter of Return of the Blue Ghost! Only at this theater!